Wildlife management is an important element in national development. This is especially so for countries like Zambia, which are endowed with a number of natural resources, including wildlife. However, statistical backing is required in effective wildlife management. Today on Your Platform, we're coming to you from the Kafue National Park as we showcase an aerial survey targeting the elephant population. This is especially important because elephants are targeted for poaching activities. However, we'll be looking at the methodology being applied in the calculation of the estimates of the elephant population in this part of the country. Welcoming you to the program, my name is Penifa Nyirenda. Thank you for staying with us on Your Platform. At this point, I'll be talking to the area warden for the northern part of the Kafue National Park, Mr. Teddy Walia. Welcome to Your Platform.
Thank you so much.
Great. Well, we'd like to begin this conversation by learning the history of the Kafue National Park from you. Please tell us more.
Yeah, indeed, the Kafue National Park is the largest national park in Zambia, and also is the oldest national park in Zambia, having been proclaimed in 1950, and it also got the full status of a national park in 1972. As we are aware, the Kafue National Park is an extent of 22,400 kilometers squared, and yeah, that's about it.
What about the animal species? What kind of animals do you have in this park?
Depending on which part of the park you are visiting, there are several species that you are likely to see. But anywhere you go in the Kafue National Park, you'll be able to see elephants, you'll be able to see lions, you'll be able to see, I think, the big five, you'll be able to see them. And also smaller antelopes like impala, puku, and many more others.
The primary interest of this particular program is the elephant population. Would like to know, as management here in the park, how do you look after these animals?
We are looking after these animals in terms of patrols. We are patrolling the greater extent of the Kafue National Park on a monthly basis, on a weekly basis, and on an annual basis. Okay. So we carry out anti-poaching patrols. The Kafue National Park by nature was occupied by some people some time back, beyond the 50s, and most of these people left the park completely in the 60s. And you find that these communities did not go too far from the Kafue National Park. So we have these communities as our neighbors. And we are getting both the positives and the negatives from the same communities. Basically, what we are doing now is work with the communities around us by involving them in conservation. But that, again, is not stopping us from continuing anti-poaching. Because as it is, for now, CBNRIM alone cannot finish poaching. We have those who are extremists, even in terms of poaching. So, I mean, we just have to continue with the also anti-poaching and also the communities working with them in partnership. Yeah.
What about the issue of human-animal conflict? Because we do know that where there are people and animals, they may not really live in harmony. How rampant are such cases in the Kafue National Park?
We have a lot of it, although most of the incursions were happening in the illegal settlements. And as such, we never had the reports from them because they knew they were in illegal settlements, especially in the Mombwa Yeme. For those who are in the settlement areas like Kahari, Chief Kahari's area, the problems that we are having is normally not farm related, but domestic animal related, where lions are straying out of the national park and then getting in conflict with the people there. But otherwise, those who have followed what is laid down in the GMPs are not having problems with us.
With regards illegal squatters, if I may call them that, do you have a lot of them in this park, and how are you dealing with them?
In the park per se, we do not have squatters as a problem, but in the game management area, we've had that problem. But I'm glad again to inform you that as of last week, we had managed to push this out, these people out, and we are also now in the process of finding them somewhere where they can settle. Chief Kahari has already offered land to some of these squatters, and we are yet to start moving them into those areas. Okay. Yeah.
Well, we've been talking to Mr. Teddy Walia, who is the warden for the northern part of the Kafue National Park. Stay tuned to your platform as we continue looking at wildlife management on today's program. Now, joining me on the program is Mr. Griffin Shanungu, who is an ecologist under the Zambia Wildlife Authority, and we'll be talking to him as we learn more about the elephant species. Welcome to your platform.
Thank you very much.
Awesome. From the onset, we'd like to learn a bit more about the characteristics of an elephant. Please tell us what makes it stand out among other animals.
Well, the elephant is the biggest land mammal that we have in Africa or in the world. You know, it is quite heavy. It's the largest of all the animals that we have. The second largest is the rhino. So the elephant is pretty charismatic animal, and it lives quite long. And yeah, it's kind of a special animal to kind of look at and just to enjoy out there in the wild.
When we look at the survey that is being conducted, there's particular interest in the elephant. Would you tell us why?
The interest of the elephant basically is to determine the current population of elephants that we have in the Kafue National Park, not only in the Kafue, but also on the Luangwa ecosystem and also the Siomangwezi and the Lower Zambezi. This part of the survey is part of a bigger survey that we're doing. We're covering the entire areas where we find elephants in Zambia. So our interest is to find out how many elephants we have in the country. And I think it's important to know how many we have in order for us to set forth management interventions to save the species from declining.
Moving on to the probably the core reason why we are here today, because there is an area survey that is being conducted and I know it's an ongoing process. Why is it that elephant count is done by aerial sight or aerial viewing? Is there a particular reason why?
It's a really good question, and it requires a technical explanation, but I think the simple explanation to that is that when you are doing surveys from the air, you cover a much bigger ground. You discover that the Kafue National Park is the largest national park we have in Zambia, and I think it ranks maybe the second or the third in Africa. So to cover such a huge expanse of land from the ground is virtually impossible. So we have to survey the park from the air, and we're not surveying each and every part of the air or of the park, but we're only sampling at 10% and 20% sampling intensity, and from there we extrapolate how many we have in terms of the larger area that we'll survey. So we just want to make estimates of how many elephants we have, and to do that, aerial surveys are the most cost efficient and more can give you much coverage in terms of how much you can cover on the ground in terms of sampling where the elephants are.
Okay. With what you've explained, I'm also keen to know if at all, with the evolution in environment or changes that we see from time to time, mm-hmm. does that have an effect on the survival of these animals in this park?
Well, animals do show an extraordinary amount of adaptability to changing environmental conditions. But the biggest problems that we face from the wildlife management point of view is the amount of poaching that we have. You would know that you know, throughout the region, elephants and rhinos are really being poached at a much faster rate than we anticipated, due to the demand for that ivory that they have. So because of that, much of the poaching is being done. And in order for us to set forth our management activities, we need to know where they are and how many that we have within these ecosystems. Okay. Yeah.
Very enlightening conversation. Would like to end here and thank you so much for being part of the program.
Thank you very much for having me. Wonderful. Thanks.
We've been talking to Mr. Griffin Shanungu, who is an ecologist under the Zambia Wildlife Authority. And of course, we're still here at the Kafue National Park as we learn more about the elephant survey that is being conducted. Stay tuned to your platform. This is your platform. Thank you so much for your company. And we are still looking at wildlife management here at the Kafue National Park, and with particular interest in the animal survey focusing on the elephants. And now joining me on the program is Dora Kamweneshe, who is the program manager for the African Elephant Area Survey under the Nature Conservancy. Welcome to your platform.
Thank you very much for this opportunity.
We're glad you could be part of our program. Please tell us about the Nature Conservancy. What kind of organization is it?
The Nature Conservancy, which is famously known as the TNC, is a leading conservation organization which has been in operation since 1951, and is operating in 33 countries all over the world, including Zambia. The mission for TNC is to conserve lands, to protect lands and water for purposes of supporting life. Basically, that's the mission. Yeah.
You have a partnership with the Zambia Wildlife Authority. Tell us a little bit more about that.
TNC has been operating in Zambia since 2010, and the Zambia Wildlife Authority has been one of the key partners that TNC has been collaborating with, particularly in the Kafue ecosystem. TNC has been collaborating with ZAWA in community-based natural resource management programs, and TNC has also been assisting basically in park management of the Kafue National Park. And in this particular case, TNC decided to partner with ZAWA in particular to conduct the elephant aerial survey in the key ecosystems in Zambia. TNC has a running financing agreement with the Vulcan Foundation of the USA, which is providing funding for ZAWA to conduct this particular aerial survey.
What about the duration of the survey? How long will it take before we can actually know the results of the survey?
This survey is basically going to last about 2 months. We are covering 4 key elephant ecosystems in Zambia. The major one is the Kafue National Park and its surrounding game management areas. This is the first area that we are conducting the aerial survey. We will also be conducting the survey in South Luangwa National Park, North Luangwa National Park, and the surrounding game management areas. The Lower Zambezi National Park is also the third ecosystem that we are going to conduct the aerial survey in. And then we are also going to conduct the aerial survey in Siomangwezi National Park. So these are the key elephant ecosystems in Zambia. I should mention also that there are other smaller pockets of elephant population here and there, but these are the key ones. So these are the ones we want to concentrate on, and hopefully they should be able to give us an estimate of the elephant population in Zambia.
Probably as we draw to a close, conducting a survey of this nature can be a costly venture. Would you tell us how much money is going into this and maybe where the funding is actually coming from?
The total aerial survey is going to cost $343,000. I should mention that all this funding is coming from the Vulcan Foundation of USA, which has partnered with TNC and also has partnered with ZAWA to conduct the aerial survey. So the bulk of this funding basically goes to Kafue National Park and the surrounding ecosystems because of the expanse of the area. So it's about $128,000 is being pumped into the Kafue National Park aerial survey, then smaller amounts to Sioma and Lower Zambezi, and also in the range of about 100,000 also for the Loangwa ecosystem. Yeah.
I would also really want to know from you when exactly this 2 months will elapse, and if at all, your impressions so far of what has been done.
So we are hoping that we could conclude the aerial survey by mid-October latest, and then the rest of the time will be used to analyze the data that we're going to collect. So it's rather premature at this stage to really give a picture of what's ongoing, because we are just at the inception of the aerial survey. So we should be able to come up with concrete information way down, especially after the analysis of the data is conducted.
We'll end there. Thank you so much for being part of the program.
Thank you very much for this opportunity. Thank you.
Well, we've been talking to Dora Kamweneshe, who is the program manager for the African Elephant Area Survey under the Nature Conservancy. Stay tuned to your platform as we continue talking or learning about the Elephant Area Survey here in the Kafue National Park. In a short while, we'll be talking to the consultant who's actually designed the survey that is being used in this area. Stay with us. Thank you so much for staying with us here on your platform. At this time on the program, we'll be talking to the consultant who actually designed the methodology being applied in actually coming up with the area survey that we are showcasing on today's program. And this is Dr. Colin Craig. Welcome to your platform.
Thank you.
We are here in the Kafue National Park, and particularly of interest to us is the area survey targeting elephants that is being conducted. Let's begin from the perspective of you enlightening us on the approach that is being taken in coming up with actually this survey.
Well, we've picked out all the areas of important elephant range in the country, and we've designed a series of sample transects over those areas. We've separated it out into peripheral elephant range and core elephant range. So we'll be fairly sure from the data that we've got most of the important elephant range in the sample, and then we'll be, in fact we are, flying transects over that, spaced at 6 kilometer intervals, and in the peripheral range, and at 3 kilometer intervals in the core range.
In terms of the efficiency, how effective is this survey design that you actually came up with?
Well, all estimates are subject to uncertainty, and it depends what you call decent. I mean, I must say I haven't actually worked out what level of uncertainty we're likely to get with this survey, but we normally aim at an estimate of the number of elephants plus or minus 20%. We'll be able to give you a preliminary estimate within about 3 weeks of the survey.
We'd like to thank you so much for being part of your platform today.
Well, it was a pleasure. Thank you for talking to me.
Well, we've been talking to Dr. Colin Craig, who is a wildlife consultant, and he's the one who designed the survey methodology that has been applied here in the Kafue National Park. In a short while, we'll be joining the American ambassador to Zambia on a flight that is actually an example of what an aerial survey is like. And much later, we'll be talking to him on his experience. Stay tuned to your platform.
Right. Whose hand am I supposed to shake first?
His hat.
Oh. See, I got my hat.
Okay.
I'm ready. How are you?
I'm okay, and you?
I'm fine. Happy to be here. Fine.
Eric, this is Dora.
Nice to meet you. Dora?
Ed Warden. I didn't catch your name, sir. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
I noticed that there are a lot fewer squatters than there used to be.
Yeah.
So I saw the PS for tourism yesterday, and he mentioned that the encroachment that they had sort of put a stop to it.
That's right, yeah.
I'd like to thank you so much for staying tuned to this week's presentation of Your Platform, where we're coming to you from the Kafue National Park, and we're actually joining the Zawa officers who are on an aerial survey trying to establish the elephant population here in the park. But joining me on the program at this point is the American ambassador to Zambia, Mr. Eric Schultz, as he'll be telling us about the partnership that some Americans have with Zawa, and of course a lot more. Welcome to the program, Your Excellency.
Pleasure to be here.
Great. We just got off an aerial sight, or at least a flight, just assessing the elephant population. Before we get into the rest of our discussion, how was that experience?
Well, you tell me, you were on the plane with me. I'm not the world's greatest flyer, frankly, and small planes kind of scare me more than most. But actually, I thought on the whole it was a very interesting experience. I can't say that the flight was smooth or anything like that, but it wasn't as bad as I was led to believe, because when I was invited to go along on this, the aerial survey, I was told to update my life insurance, and I think that was an exaggeration.
Absolutely. We'll start off, Your Excellency, from the perspective of wildlife management. How do you think we're performing in that area?
Sure. I think if you... I mean, that's a very interesting sort of place to start, because I think it's the correct place to start, and it's the right term to use, manage your wildlife. Tourists come to Zambia primarily to see the wildlife, and tourism is one of the aspects of the Zambian economy that has the most potential for future growth. If you don't have wildlife, though, you won't get increased numbers of tourists. And arguably, Zambia kind of underperforms from a tourism point of view. You get 150 to 200,000 tourists a year, something like that. The plurality of those are actually Americans, something like 35 to 40%. It's really extremely important, I think, to the future of the country, to the future of Zambia's economy, that you manage your wildlife, preserve your wildlife. And I think the place that you have to start with that, the single sort of, maybe not the most important thing, but the place you have to start from, is you need an accurate estimate of the numbers of wildlife that you have. You can't really manage the wildlife population properly unless you know how many you have. And if you know how many you have, then you know how many you can, for instance, allow to be hunted. So I think getting an accurate count is the most important thing. Let me start off also by just saying how much I appreciate ZAWA and the Nature Conservancy for inviting me along on this aerial survey. The ZAWA officers are the ones who are actually conducting the survey. They're the ones who are doing the counting. But the logistics are being handled by the Nature Conservancy, and that's via a grant from Paul Allen, who is actually probably richer than the American government in some respects. It's great that Americans care so much about the environment now, and that an individual like Paul Allen sees fit to underwrite the costs of something like the African Elephant Initiative.
Do you think African governments are investing as much in wildlife management, and particularly activities like what we're witnessing today, an aerial survey of the animal species that they actually have in their countries?
I would say that with any form of assistance, almost regardless of what it is, in the end, if it matters to a country, if it's important to a country, they need to find a way to pay for it for themselves. Again, it comes back to the growth potential in the tourism industry. If tourism in Zambia is generating sufficient revenue, then Zambia ought really to be able to afford to do these kinds of surveys without outside assistance. In the interval, it's great that someone like Paul Allen steps up and fills the gap. I would say that that you can't do these as kind of a one-off. I mean, you have to do aerial surveys. You have to do estimates of the number of animals pretty much on an annual basis, so that you have an idea of what the trend line is.
I'm keen to bring you to specifically talk about the elephant, because that's mm-hmm. actually the animal targeted for this survey. What do you think would be the best way for us to manage this animal species, because it is endangered to a great extent?
I would agree with that, but I think that there are other animals that fall into the same category. I'm neither me nor my government are opposed to responsible, sustainable hunting. I think that should be said at the outset. On the other hand, I think that that if you just look at the numbers, photographic tourism, so you know, photographic safaris, are a much greater potential source of employment and revenue than is hunting. I think that ultimately, when you're trying to manage wildlife, part of what you're doing is you're trying to get an accurate estimate of the numbers, and then on the basis of that, you can determine how many licenses for a particular species you can allow for hunting purposes. The problem that you have, obviously, in Zambia in general, but in Kafue in particular, is the problem of poaching. You don't really get a sense of just how big this park is until you're up in a plane flying around. I mean, we went an hour and a half north, and I don't think we even came close to the edge of the park. So it's an absolutely enormous park. It's the size of Massachusetts. And trying to patrol that, to monitor it, is an enormous task for ZAWA and for the Zambian government. But I think it's also an essential task, because if you're not able to monitor it effectively, then it's one thing to be issuing licenses for legal hunting. It's another thing when poaching is occurring and is endangering the survival of the species. And if you look at the history of elephants in Africa, the numbers are dwindling, no question about it. And the primary reason for that is not hunting per se, it's poaching. It's basically killing the elephants for their tusks.
Let me take you away from there and maybe just put you on a larger perspective in terms of the American government support to Zambia, but more to the tourism industry. Mm-hmm. I do know that you support health and I think segments of education, but would you give us an outline in terms of the support to tourism industry by the American government?
Sure. So we have a very large assistance budget with Zambia. It's on the order of about $500 million a year. But the bulk of that actually goes for HIV/AIDS relief through the President's Emergency Program for AIDS Relief. And then we also donate money to the Global Fund, which in turn provides money to Zambia for the same purpose. We also actually give quite a bit of money under the President's Malaria Initiative, President Obama. Both of those programs, very successful, have done a lot, I think, to in partnership with the Zambian government to improve the health of Zambians. And that's been a priority from an assistance point of view of us for some time. Other things that we provide, we have a thing called Feed the Future, which is designed to help smallholders sort of diversify away from maize and towards cash crops, and in the process improve their livelihoods. We have, of course, the MCC, which I is a huge project, which is designed to bring reliable, potable water to the greater Lusaka area, again, in conjunction with the Zambian government. When it comes to tourism per se, we don't have projects that are specifically geared towards tourism, economic development projects. What we try to do, of course, is to encourage Americans to continue to come to Zambia. Frankly, the biggest problem that you have from that point of view is the lack of a direct flight from Europe. I just came back from the United States myself. I was there for a week. It took me 36 hours to get back from Washington. The bottom line is, if you're an American tourist, you have to really want to come to Zambia. And pretty much the reason Americans come here is because it's such a beautiful country, because the environment, the nature is so spectacular, and more to the point, because they've either been here before or they know, sorry, tsetse flies, or they know someone who has been here before. So it's sort of word of mouth. Part of what I try to do is just amplify what the government is doing and encourage tourists to come here.
Okay. Any final words in wrapping up?
When you take a flight around here, it really brings home to you not just how large this park is and how difficult the task is for ZAWA and for the Zambian government and for the Ministry of Tourism, but it also brings home to you what an incredibly beautiful country it is. The weather couldn't be any better. So it was a lot of fun actually taking a flight with you.
We'd like to thank you so much for making time to be part of your platform.
My pleasure.
Great. We've been talking to the American ambassador to Zambia, Mr. Eric Schultz, as we were talking about wildlife management and, of course, his experience in being part of the aerial survey conducted by the Zambia Wildlife Authority offices. Stay tuned to your platform. You're watching this week's presentation of Your Platform, and we're still here in the Kafue National Park, and we are continuing to look at our subject of wildlife management in Zambia, and particularly focusing on the aerial survey being conducted in this park. And like I did mention earlier in the program, the Kafue National Park is one of four sites where the Zambia Wildlife Authority is trying to establish the elephant population in the country. At this point of the program, we'll be talking to the acting head of research at the Zambia Wildlife Authority, Mr. Jones Masonde. Welcome to Your Platform.
Yes, thank you.
As we begin our interview, I'd like to learn from you, and of course for the benefit of our viewers, what does the Zambia Wildlife Authority actually do?
The Zambia Wildlife Authority is a statutory body that's mandated to look after wildlife and wildlife estates in Zambia. It was formed under the Zambia Wildlife Act of 1998 to protect wildlife in Zambia generally.
Here in the Kafue National Park, we're particularly interested in the area survey that is being undertaken, and I do believe from what we've established so far that the emphasis is basically on the elephant population. Please tell us about this survey.
Okay, the survey we are conducting is a part of the Greater Pan-African Survey of Elephants. It's being done throughout the entire Africa. So Zambia is participating through the Zambia Wildlife Authority to estimate the population of elephants. This survey is sponsored by a consortium of NGOs. The Falcon Incorporation and the Paul Allen Foundation. In Zambia, it's being managed and coordinated by the Nature Conservancy TNC, and implementation is actually by the Zambia Wildlife Authority.
How significant is the Kafue National Park to the Zambia Wildlife Authority?
Okay, the Kafue National Park is the largest ecosystem harboring wildlife that we have, spanning over 65,000 square kilometers, and so it harbors a large number of wild animals, some of which are endemic and as significant to the sector. But it also provides other ecosystem services beyond wildlife, which other industries access, such as the water. As you know, the Kafue National Park is the Kafue River is a large part of it is found in the park. There's also fish that comes from the park, which the community, surrounding communities access.
We are particularly interested in the elephant survey that is being conducted. Enlighten us on this activity.
The survey will take approximately a month to complete. It benefits the country in that the information that we get from the survey helps in informing decision making for tourism. The Zambia Wildlife Authority uses this information to help in management of wildlife. The estimates helps us to, for instance, set off-take quotas, what we call off-take quotas. These off-take quotas are for hunting and for live capture of animals. And so there's a lot of revenue that is generated from these quotas. But they have to be set and based on scientific basis, hence the surveys.
Ultimately, do we see more of this kind of activity being undertaken? Because you did mention that it's within your mandate, but with the cost factor and all that, do we still see a continuation of surveys, maybe even targeting other animal species?
Yes. To start with, ZAWA is taking advantage of this good gesture by the Vulcan to count even other animals beyond the elephant. Although the elephant is the major target, we are still going to count other animals. But these surveys are routine work that Zambia Wildlife Authority does ideally every 3 years. So the last survey was in 2013, and we hope that after the 2015 maybe in 2018 we'll do another survey, an aerial survey. But in between, there are smaller, short surveys that are conducted to supplement information, because there are some animals that can't easily be picked through an aerial survey. So those have to be done using other methods.
In terms of the approach being used in conducting the survey, we have noticed that the emphasis has been placed on an aerial perspective. We did ask this question earlier, but for the sake of maybe emphasis, why are elephants calculated in the air?
Okay, the estate that the Zambia Wildlife Authority looks after is quite huge. Kafue National Park ecosystem alone is over 65,000 that we are looking at. The Luangwa ecosystem is over another 60,000. So it's not possible to do these surveys on foot using any other method other than the aerial surveys. The aerial surveys allows us to do the work within a short time. And mind you, as we are doing the surveys, the animals are not static, they are moving. So if you were going to do a ground count of the Kafue National Park, you would need first of all a huge manpower, and it will bring distortions in the information, because by the time you finish then from the north getting to the south, the animals have been moving up and down, so you will not get a correct picture, as opposed to doing it in the air. Yeah.
As we probably conclude this particular interview, what would be maybe your closing remarks, and even as you do so, yet again emphasizing on the significance of an activity like this one?
All right. This activity is very important. It's very costly. It cost us almost the 10% of our budget as a department. And so we rely heavily on donor support to do this kind of work. But it is very critical, because it provides support to what we are doing, the decisions that management has to make, and so that they are science-based. We don't make random decisions. We have to, for instance, guide our hunting based on the figures that we get from here. But we also use these surveys to even collect other information beyond even animals. For instance, we capture information on encroachment in the park. Any illegal activities are also captured through this survey, which helps to inform our law enforcement units.
We'll end there. Thank you so much for being part of our program today.
Thank you very much for coming along.
We've been talking to Mr. Johns Masonde, who is the acting head of research at the Zambia Wildlife Authority. And of course, we've been here at the Kafue National Park, where an aerial survey is being conducted to calculate, or at least arrive at, estimates of the animal population here in the park. And we have learned that this park is not the only site where the elephant population is being calculated, but it's one of four. Well, here's where we end the program. We'd like to thank you so much for your company, and we do encourage you to join us next week at the very same time, as we'll have another interesting program. My name is Penifa Nyirenda. On behalf of my camera operator, Nelson Njovu, it's goodbye and God bless you.